The new head of Al-Qaeda identified. Both the United Nations and the U.S. say Saif al-Adel, an Iran-based Egyptian, has become the de facto leader of the terrorist group following the July 2022 killing of Ayman al-Zawahiri. But according to the U.N.'s report, the group has not formally declared Adel as emir in deference to Taliban authorities in Afghanistan who do not want to acknowledge Zawahiri's death. Adel is a former Egyptian Special Forces officer who helped build the group's operational capacity and trained some of the hijackers who took part in the September 11 attacks on the U.S. He has a $10 million bounty on his head. The Office of Civil Defense says there's no need for the Philippine Rescue Team to extend their two-week stay there. Let's get more details from ABS-CBN correspondent Bianca Dava. Bianca?
Hi, Ron. There is no need for the Philippine contingent to extend their two-week stay to help in the search, rescue, and relief efforts in Crete, Turkey, OCD spokesperson Bernardo Rafaelito Alejandro IV said on Thursday. Since they started their operations in their area of assignment at Adiyaman province on February 10, the Philippines response team has swept through 34 buildings destroyed by the quake in search for survivors. But so far, they have only recovered dead bodies, according to Alejandro. The country's emergency medical assistance team has catered to ambulatory cases and referrals requiring hospitalization, serving 256 patients from February 11 to 15. The team also continues to provide medical assistance to the Philippine contingent, ensuring the welfare of the team with standby doctors and nurses. Upon completing their mission and returning to the Philippines, the 82-person response team will undergo stress debriefing and counseling, according to MMDA Chairman Romando Artes. Meanwhile, the Philippine government will send cash donation for the victims of the deadly quake in Syria. Alejandro said the Department of Foreign Affairs is only waiting for the approval of the cash donation. The official did not specify the amount to be donated, but noted that the funds would come from either the Office of the President or the DFA. Ron?
Bianca Dava with that story. Thanks.
Two low-pressure areas off Mindanao have started to merge. How will this affect the weather here in the Philippines? Well, let's find out from PAGASA forecaster Raymond Ordinario. Raymond?
Yes, Denise, good afternoon, and Ron, and to our followers. And this is our forecast for the next 24 hours. Yes, Denise, you're mentioning that we are monitoring two low-pressure areas. The one inside our area of responsibility was last spotted around 1,050 kilometers east of southeastern Mindanao. And its trough is now bringing cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over Caraga and Davao region. Meanwhile, another low-pressure area outside the Philippine area of responsibility is spotted around 1,165 kilometers east of northeastern Mindanao. In the our forecast scenario, it is expected to merge within the two low-pressure area, and it might affect the Visayas and southern Luzon area this coming weekend. And now the northeast monsoon is still affecting Luzon and Visayas, bringing cloudy skies with rains over Cagayan Valley, Cordillera, Aurora, Quezon, and Bicol region. Meanwhile, Visayas, Metro Manila, and the rest of Luzon, we're going to expect generally fair weather condition apart from some light rains. The rest of Mindanao, we're going to expect generally fair weather condition as well with isolated rain showers or thunderstorm. In Metro Manila, the temperature will range from 22 to 30 degrees Celsius. Baguio City is 13 to 24, and in Tagaytay City is around 19 to 29 degrees Celsius. And due to the surge of our northeast monsoon, we now have gale warning raised over Ilocos Norte, Ilocos Sur, La Union, Pangasinan, Batanes, Cagayan, Babuyan Island, Isabela, Aurora, Quezon, the entire Polillo Island, Camarines Norte, Camarines Sur, Catanduanes, Albay, Sorsogon, Northern Samar, Eastern Samar, Samar, Leyte, Southern Leyte. Here in Metro Manila, Zambales, Bataan, Batangas, Occidental Mindoro, Lubang Island, Oriental Mindoro, Palawan, Marinduque, Romblon, Antique, Aklan, Iloilo, Guimaras, Capiz, Bohol, Negros Occidental, Negros Oriental, Cebu, Bohol, Siquijor, Agusan del Norte, Misamis Oriental, Misamis Occidental, the northern coast of Lanao del Norte, Surigao del Norte, Surigao del Sur, Dinagat Island, and Davao Oriental. We are advising our fisher folks and those who have small sea crafts not to venture out of these seabirds because we're still expecting a high wave that might reach up to 5.5 meters. And that's the latest from the Weather Forecasting Center of Pagasa, Raymond Ordinario reporting.
Thanks, Raymond.